Well, Michael Catlow here again with another episode of 15 Minutes of Fame with the infamous Angie Mattson. I'm really excited about this video today. Today is the 16th of February,
yes,
I think it is. And it's a rainy day here in Charlotte, kind of nasty, kind of icky. But I've known Angie now for, I guess,
a couple years, two years or so.
And so excited to do this video. And one of the things I'm most excited about is because when we sat down, I said, so what are we going to talk about? And Angie said...
I have no idea.
So we're going to see where this goes. I think we have a starting point on where it's going to go. But we have our trusty 15 Minutes of Fame clock here. And we're about to get started.
Here we go.
So are we ready?
Let's do it.
Okay. Ready? Oh, and just so you know, I always like to tell everybody, as we get towards the end, I might say we got 2 minutes left. Anything you want to say to the world, and we'll kind of see where it goes. So... here we go. Uh-huh. All right, so we're here with Angie Mattson again. So Angie, tell us a little bit about you, first of all.
So I'm Angie Mattson. I am Chief Efficiency Officer of Your Organized Guide, formerly Mattson Business Services, but no one could spell Mattson, so I had to take it off the company name. I work with business owners and their teams to get them organized and out of overwhelm.
So Chief Efficiency Officer.
Yes.
That's an official title.
Yes, I'm CEO of my company.
But it is an exceptionally descriptive title
as well. Yes.
Okay, so tell us a little bit about, first of all, what that means, what you do for people. I know we gave a quick little synopsis, but maybe a couple stories or so.
Yep. So usually a potential client comes to me and they say, I'm totally overwhelmed. I have no time to do things. I can't see my desk. In some cases, I can't see my floor because of the piles that are around. I'm working all the time, nights and weekends, and now I'm starting to see things slipping through the cracks. I'm starting to feel really stressful, and I'll look at them, and they have that pinched look around their eyes, like they're just holding on by their fingernails.
Right. Crevices in the forehead.
Yes. Deep, deep worry lines, squinty from tired, drinking lots of coffee.
So why do you think people get that way? Is it just a personality trait that they maybe get overwhelmed and have stuff on their desk or too busy or varying reasons probably?
It's varying reasons. Some people have just never been taught how to be organized.
Interesting.
So they don't have the skills that they need. And one of the things I'm really seeing, because we are so overloaded in this information age, is people literally don't know how to handle the amount of information coming at them now.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Interesting.
There's just so much, and it comes because we all have two or three phones, we have two addresses, we've got fax numbers, most of us have up to 3, 4, 5 email addresses that we're trying to check.
Or 10.
And now you can set up RSS feeds, and you get all these e-zine subscriptions, and there's just so much coming at you.
So how did you learn how to do all that stuff? Because most people have never been taught that before.
Right. I'm naturally organized. I naturally look for patterns.
You're a much needed person in a lot of people's lives.
I naturally see patterns, and so I have organized myself in things that I can handle. So I can handle buckets of information, I can see a pattern and make order and put a system in it, and it turns out that because I'm a business owner, I can talk to other business owners and help them get systematized.
Now, can you identify somebody else's systems and pattern right away?
Not always right away, but there's always a pattern there. And if I work with them long enough, I can find it.
And a pattern would be like this is for clarity, like a sales process, so the thing where things need to go, or just filing, or what exactly is a pattern?
All those things. It's the kinds of information that come into your office, what you should be doing with the information, so the doing of it, and then where it should go when you're done.
So everything from business cards, from networking groups, emails, Facebook messages, contracts, customer inquiries, all that type of stuff.
Yes. So I have 5 essential business systems that every business owner needs.
Are we allowed to say those on camera? Or,
sure.
Or are they special? 5 essential business systems.
Yes.
Okay.
The first one is getting clients. And that involves all the networking, business cards, sales and marketing, all that kind of stuff.
Definitely one of 5 essentials.
Getting
for sure.
Clients, okay?
Okay.
The second one is doing the work.
Okay.
So it's whomever does the work in your business, whether it's you or you have employees, so getting the work done and all the systems that go with that. Getting paid. So that includes, are you invoicing regularly? Are you collecting money? Are you making sure? And are you depositing checks? I have clients that lose checks because they have no system for managing them.
Interesting.
Yeah.
You think that would be really important.
You would think that people would be...
And it probably is important, but it just gets mixed up.
It just gets lost in all the stuff.
Right.
The fourth essential business system is just running the business. Like, do you have a way to review your financials every year? Are you looking at where your referrals come from? Are you making sure that your domain name isn't expiring and you're losing all of your website information? And then the fifth one is the owner's mindset. And there are very specific things that I think business owners should be doing, including investing in their own education.
Got it.
To be a good business owner.
On that, kind of change gears a little half second, but on these as well. You do workshops and stuff as well, correct?
Yes.
Well, actually, so let me back up. So you can go work with an individual client, and do you work with some on just a one-time basis, on regular occurring?
Generally, I like to work with somebody for 3 to 6 months.
Okay.
Yep. So the first month is a discovery phase, the second month is an implementation, and the third month is accountability.
And then fourth, fifth, and sixth would be just kind of follow-ups on all that stuff?
It depends. If somebody really needs a lot of help, sometimes it takes 6 months to run, so it's 2 months of each, 2 months of each of those.
Got it. So if you're working with a client, obviously that's hands-on, so they're going to learn that way. But then I know we were talking, you also do speaking engagements and workshops and all of that stuff.
Yep.
And there, people can gather enough knowledge just from coming to those to get things started?
To get started, yes.
Got it?
Absolutely.
We were talking as we got here as well about some crazy stories, all types of people and everything.
Yeah.
Give us maybe 30 seconds of a typical type person, typical type office that you might walk into. So somebody who's watching this video, if they're watching from their office, they might look around and say, wow, I could really use potentially your organized guide.
Okay.
That makes sense?
Yeah, absolutely. Yep. So a typical person's office, who could really use your organized guide, has a slew of business cards in different places all around. There are either sticky notes or little bits of paper or envelopes with names, numbers, notes, reminders, to-dos kind of spread everywhere, sticking out of everywhere.
Can I stop you there for a second?
Yeah.
Because I talk to people often who say they're the sticky note king or the sticky note queen, but it gets kind of crazy.
It gets kooky. I went into one person's office and they had sticky notes all around their computer.
And they sit there forever sometimes.
I'm like, do you ever take action on those?
I've seen sticky note on top of sticky note on top of sticky note on top of sticky note.
And they layer them. Like, how?
Okay, so somebody who has multiple sticky notes, what do you...
Could be. If it's inefficient and not working for them.
Right.
They either don't have time to get to the things that are on the sticky note, or they forget about it. It becomes background noise.
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay, so some other things we might see.
Yep. So one of the other things that I see is people will have client information in 5 different places.
The same client.
Same client information everywhere. They have not learned how to contain things.
Now that could, here's a question as well, because this is something we're actually dealing with internally in one of our businesses.
Yep.
Even if it's not like 5 pieces of information, we might have a spreadsheet, another spreadsheet, which has contact info that don't communicate with each other and so forth. So if we change something in one place, it doesn't change in another.
Right. So you're either doing duplicate entry or you're forgetting to update all 6 places that need to be updated.
Absolutely. Yeah. And so you can help with things like that?
Yes.
Systematizing and implementing that stuff?
Yep. So we always look at the information first. We talk about the fundamental ways to organize information. And usually we do it on paper. And then we talk about, well, is there software available to make all this work together?
Right.
Sometimes there is, sometimes there isn't.
Right. I have got to imagine, if you could even just help people with that aspect, that could be exceptionally overwhelmingly good to help them increase production, increase money, and all that stuff.
Right. Huh. Right.
So any organizing tips that are kind of general tips you could give people? And I know that's kind of a general question. Everybody's got different needs. But
no. Well, I can give you 30 organizing tips, but you'd have to go to my website. I have 30 organizing videos. They're all under 2 minutes long.
Okay.
And most of them are physical organizing, so stuff that's in your space.
Okay.
I
still remember, at one of our meetings when you talked about that you've got cables hanging off the back of your desk and you take the binder clip.
Yeah.
I could show you binder clips that I have on my desk
from
a year and a half ago or whatever. So the little 2-minute videos are awesome. Okay, I interrupted you. I'm sorry.
Yeah. So the big things about organization, your brain is not for remembering.
Interesting.
Your brain is for creating and dreaming up things and thinking. Your software, your tools are for remembering. So your brain's not for remembering. Especially as we get busier and more information comes at us.
It's really powerful.
Yeah. Your brain is not for remembering.
Brain's for creating, not remembering. Mm. Tools are for remembering.
That's right.
Okay.
And reminding. Put like. When you're organizing, especially when you think of office supplies, paper products, magazines and newspapers, put like with like.
Right.
Keep it all in the same area. That way you're not going over here for paper and over there for envelopes and over there for pencils. Put like with like.
So sometimes, in other words, use common sense.
It's not common sense for everybody, though.
Well, you know, yeah, no, I'm saying for me.
Yeah, I don't like to say it's common sense because it's not for some people. That's
right.
Not how their brain
never been
works.
Taught how to...
They've never been taught that.
That's fascinating.
Yeah.
So what's your messaging you use to people to actually get them to? Do you have to ask questions just in prospecting a client?
Right.
I guess. Do you have certain questions that you ask people that automatically triggers for them? Wow, I might be able to need your services.
So some of the questions I ask are, how many emails do you have in your inbox? Because usually, if they tell me they have more than 100. Mm-hmm. There's probably a problem there.
Mm-hmm.
I ask them, do you know what to do with your business cards? Because that's another big, giant thing. If I know they have employees, I ask them, how's the communication
right. Between
you and your employees? Do you feel comfortable sitting down and talking through a process?
Right.
And some people want a third party to do that.
Sure. Yeah, I would imagine.
So.
Got it.
And then, are you working on weekends? And
right.
you don't want to be. That's
right.
another big clue.
Got it.
That there's... some inefficiencies there.
Got it. Inefficiencies. Big word.
Mm-hmm.
So what are some of the goals for the business?
Ooh. Big juicy goals for the business. So.
By the way, I love Angie Mattson. You have to meet her. We got big juicy goals.
Big juicy goals. So I am adding team members because there are people out there who are actually better than me at processes. So when we work with teams... adding team members that can come in and help with, for instance, the financial processes. I just found somebody. She's fabulous. She does a great job with it. A couple of administrative assistants to help me with flowcharts and notes and all that kind of stuff. And I want to launch half-day seminars, full-day seminars, and weekend seminars
okay. To
teach business owners at an affordable price how to systematize their businesses
sure. And
do
sure. Those
five essential business systems.
Sure. Is there benefits, I would have to imagine there is, in a group coming together and
yes. Learning
from each other outside of just from you kind of instructing?
Absolutely, because everybody's using different software or they're all using the same software in a little bit different way.
Right.
People have great ideas. So
sure. The
groupthink mentality is
sure. Wonderful. Sure.
Crowdsourcing.
So with any of the workshops or anything like that, how would people get... aware of those? Do you have a newsletter or...
I do.
You do?
Yep. So
okay. If
you go to yourorganizedguide.com, there is a button that says click here and you can download my free report on one simple step to finding focus for business owners and then four tips for keeping it. And then you'll be on my regular newsletter and you'll hear about all the new classes that I'm having. Any specials that I'm doing, which I'm doing an email special soon.
Okay, so get on the email.
Get on the list.
On the newsletter, do you give tips and stuff like that on there as well?
Yep. I release new videos via my newsletter and give lots of tips and thoughts and strategies for people. So
got it.
I give a lot of free information.
Good. Well, it's such valuable.
Yeah.
It's gracious.
I mean, everybody needs it.
And there's probably no limit, so even if you get a little nugget, you still need extra help or new ideas and so forth.
Sure. Well, and so the thing is, with the e-zine and my videos and even my blogs, you get piecemeal information, but it's not in an organized system.
Got it.
That unless you work really hard, you can't put it together
in the
way that I teach it. So.
Sure. I can't believe we just went through 13 minutes. Okay. So if we had a minute and 43 seconds for you to say anything to the world, right?
Yes.
This is your platform. Anything
yes. You'd
want to share? Anything come to mind?
Oh my goodness.
Maybe a business owner's philosophy?
I guess I approach my work and my life from a little different way than most people do. Because I really believe that we're here to be in relationship with each other. And so in my business and in my life, my relationships are the most important thing. Sure, I want to make money, and I'm not shy about telling people that. But when it comes down to it, I want to work with you as a human being and to get you out of stress and overwhelm so that you can go and do the fun things on the weekend that you want to do. So
right.
I'm a backpacker, I'm a hiker, I'm a kayaker. And I reserve my weekends for those fun things.
Sure.
When I hear business owners that don't have
that
time,
can't do that.
They're just
do
so
that.
Swamped and overwhelmed.
Right.
It's like my goal in life to get you freed up from that.
Really important philosophy to come from, I think.
Yeah.
Especially within the business. Not just about making the money, not just about that.
Right.
Or even about the systems or implementing the stuff.
Right.
To be able to go have fun on the weekends
right.
and do those wonderful things.
Right. It's about having time to do the things in life that are important. Go home at night and have dinner with your family for a change, you know?
I've got chicken parmesan and spaghetti tonight.
Nice,
home cooked. Well, you're not coming over, you're already here.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so we got 15 seconds. Anything 15 else?
15 seconds. No, just approach people with love. Smile at them. Shake their hand. Just be genuine and honest. And it makes life way better.
For sure.
Yeah.
Well, the 2 years are... well, look at that. Look at that. There we are. We are officially done. But with the... I guess we'll say 2 years for sake of ease. In and out of different networking groups and different things.
Yes.
I, Michael Catlow, give Angie Madsen 2 thumbs up. Not that that means anything whatsoever. But she's one of the good people in the world. This was a fun video.
Yeah.
And as we started to do the 15 minutes of fame videos, one of the first cards... I went through all my cards. I actually have them in an organized way for myself that works for me. I started saying, who are the people I'd love to do videos with? And you were one of the very first people that, as I pulled the card out, I'd like, absolutely have to do one with Angie. So,
awesome.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.
I appreciate it.
Very
Is
good.
It okay if we put your contact info and any of that stuff? If you'll make sure, just send me a little email and I'll put all that little blurb in there.
Sure.
Make sure to contact with Angie and your organized guide. And this is 15 Minutes of Fame. If you have something you'd like to share, talk about your business, talk about a project, talk about life, talk about whatever it is you want to do, we will get you on video. And we'll talk to you next time.
Bye.